All right. So once we reabsorbed our solutes, that causes the lumen of the tubule to become hypotonic. And if you recall, hypo means less, tonic means solute. So we have less solute in the lumen because we've reabsorbed those solutes. So if there's less solute, now we know there's more water, right? They're relative to one another. So now we created an osmotic gradient. And now water can be reabsorbed. Urea, remember what urea is. So if we have, we have a protein, right? So a protein consists of amino acids all held together via a peptide bond, right? And when we undergo proteolysis, remember, is gonna give us individual amino acids. And if we zoom in on one amino acid, we know that we have a central carbon. We know there's an R group. We know there's an H group. We know that there's an NH2 group and a carboxyl group. What ends up happening is that we cleave off this NH2 group, which becomes ammonia. That becomes ammonia. That goes off to the liver, and then the liver converts ammonia into urea. Okay, ammonia is toxic, so you want to convert it into urea. So urea is a small polar molecule that uses simple diffusion to get across that membrane or to be reabsorbed. So that concludes reabsorption in the proximal convoluted tubule. Next, we're going to focus on the loop of Henle.